shows.
Well, one of the fun things about this, Billy, is that we get to play our really good guitars for this thing, right? Bring out the good stuff. You still get that custom Telecaster that was on the cover of the record?
Yeah.
I do have to do a single show.
Yeah, that's a cool guitar.
My friend Spencer Drake knows about that guitar. Spencer is somewhere in the Don't Say No album cover, so he knows that guitar very well. It's a blues-themed evening, it appears. And it's all still going back to Robert Johnson. We have a small little pocket that we like to kind of fit in, but... What's that? We might be able to do that, but not now. I like that song. I'm going to sing it. Maybe. We'll see if we can do it. But this is another Robert Johnson song. Who here knows the title of any Robert Johnson song? Okay, we got Love and Pain, and we got probably the one that you all should have said, which was Crossroads.
We had a few Crossroads.
Love and Pain's a good one. We don't want to besmirch the reputation of our friends in the Rolling Stones. So we'll put this off on their manager. The Stones did Love in Vain.
They sure did.
They did it. And years after that, I always used to read liner notes and stuff, but maybe I wasn't as much into, when I was a kid, looking at, like, writing the songs, remembering things like that. But anyway, Love in Vain, the Rolling Stones, it's credited to Mick Jagger and Keith Richards.
Really?
And I discovered this later, and I went, you've got to be fucking kidding. How could they do that? Keith is a huge blues fan. I mean, the Stones are all blues fans. They grew up on that stuff. And, you know, Brian Jones was a big blues guitar player. He started that whole thing with them. You know, I thought, how could these guys be doing this? And then they later, many years after that, I think they retracted it, and they paid some. But I mean, why would you do that?
They didn't do it. You're right. It was the management that did it. Yeah.
No, for real. No, I believe that. I said, this is so bizarre. These guys who've been so influential in bringing that music to all of us.
Yeah.
You know.
But, I mean, you know those guys.
And certainly, have written a few good songs of their own. They don't really need. You know, they don't need.
You know those guys. I work with Mick, you know, and Mick knows his blues.
Yeah.
You know, he would take me to see, like, Lowell Fulsom and stuff. He took me to this little club one time to see Lowell Fulsom. He said, man, and he sat at a table right up front, you know, like, no fooling around, no, like, hey, I'm Mick Jagger, you know, none of that. We're going to sit up front, we're going to watch Lowell Fulsom. You know, they're into it. So I don't think that was them. But we're going to do this here.
Nobody's trying to take credit for doing Crossroads.
Billy would come over to my house and we would rehearse. You know, mainly we'd sit around and talk about stuff like this. You know, like, oh yeah, remember that record? Remember that time? Did you hear the story about, you know, that stuff? Yeah, but we can do some playing.
We do a little playing. Yeah. three. Thank you. I believe